What is going on YouTube? It is your boy Wingstop Hobby. Back to another video. Three videos in 2 days. I know, pretty big high upload rate for me. However, we have another sneaker unboxing. And this is the most hyped shoe of the year by far. Actually, the high top version is probably the most hyped up shoe. But anyways, in today's unboxing, you guys see it right here. We're going to be talking about these bad boys, the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1 Low collaboration with Fragment. I think I probably said that wrong. The Air Jordan 1 Low, Travis Scott times Fragment, triple collab. This is my first ever triple collab, so I'm really not used to it. And yeah, anyways, I cannot wait to share my thoughts and opinions on these shoes with you guys, because just for beginners, I'm not the biggest Travis Scott fan. I like his music, but I'm no fanboy. I'm not like a huge Fragment design fan. So this is going to be a totally unbiased, non-hypebeast opinion on these, because I know these are going for a lot of money. I'm going to tell you guys, in my honest opinion, do I think these are worth the current resale price that these are going for? But before we get into today's video, as always, please hit like, subscribe, and feel free to follow me on Instagram down below to see how I style all my sneakers and outfits. I'm not sure if these are going on feet, but if they do go on feet, I'm definitely going to be posting a fit pic in the gram. So go feel free to go follow my Instagram to see if I do put these on my feet. But anyways, let's just get right into it. So first and foremost, shout out to FedEx for delivering my package. They had me sweating. I'm not going to lie. I'm sure if some of you guys have Instagram or like Twitter or social media, people were starting rumors that FedEx was stealing packages. Well, truth be told, they were just super far behind. And I forgot when these came out, actually. I think it was like last week. So they took like a week to get to me, which is not like the end of the world. But usually Nike delivers to me in like 2 days. So like I said, I was sweating it out. But I'm so thankful that nothing happened to these, because that L would have hit differently. But anyways, let's get into this box. So the box did come with this nice little box cover, which has a Fragment Design logo on it. It has the Nike Air logo. It's got the Air Jordan Wings logo. It's got the Cactus Jack logo. It's got this other Cactus Jack logo. And yeah, pretty nice clear covering. Protects the box, but other than that, nice little packaging. Getting into our regular box, we do have a white Nike box. Really do like the color of this box, by the way. It looks super dope. And you can see the white or blue Nike Air. Our sizing label reads Air Jordan 1 Low, OG SP. SP stands for Special Project. Our color code is going to be SAIL, Military Blue Black, US 10.5, which is my size. And on the inside, you get this pink Travis Scott Fragment Design paper, and you guys could see all the logos on this paper. So similar to the first couple Travis Scott Air Jordan 1s, they both came with pink paper. These are no different. I actually did have the first Travis Scott Air Jordan 1 Lows, but I had to sell them because last year I needed money, and yeah, I had to get rid of those. Anyways, glad to have another one in my collection though, so let's just get right into it. And here they are, the Air Jordan 1 Low Travis Scott Fragment collab. And honestly guys, I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, I've been a big hater of Travis Scott shoes. On Instagram, I kind of like got tired of the Travis Scott Air Jordans, I'm not gonna lie. But when I saw these, the low top version, which I have in my hand, when I saw these, I was like, unbiased opinion towards like Travis Scott or any hype piece, these are generally fire. Like, I really think they did a good job on these. And honestly, I'm not even like a huge fan of blue shoes either. Now, maybe I'm giving into the hype a little bit, but for some reason, like this cream swoosh going up on the side with this cream midsole, it just looks so damn good. I just don't know what it is. I mean, it just looks magnificent. And this color blocking is definitely better than the high tops by like a mile. Like the high tops to me, like, I wasn't even interested in those, to be honest with you. I mean, I went for them because they sell for $5,000. Even if I would have got the high tops for retail, I wouldn't have thought about even wearing these. Like, I'm actually thinking about wearing these because I like them so much. And obviously, I'm not a reseller or anything like that, and I just generally like shoes. But honestly, with a shoe like this, it is tough to wear, because once you put it to the ground, that's that. It's. I mean, not saying I can't get some money for it, but still, it is like a $1,300, which we'll get into later. But anyways, get into some of the details and the quality on the shoe. Honestly, the quality is nothing like too insane to me. It feels pretty standard. Honestly, the leather on the Syracuse Dunk Lows last year that came out in 2020, the leather feels a little better on those. Just my opinion, don't shoot the messenger. But other than that, it's nothing really too special. I do like the Fragment hit on the back. And then on the left shoe, we got the Travis Scott logo. Also, you get three pairs of spare laces. You get a blue pair, you get a pink pair, and you get a black pair. And then they obviously come with the cream pair already in them. In my opinion, the cream pair is probably going to look the best. The pink second. I'd probably go black third and then blue fourth. That's just me like trying to visualize what it looks like. So those are just my opinions. But what I do like, and one of my favorite touches of the shoe, which is kind of like a hidden detail, is the pink trim on the inside of this swoosh. Hopefully the camera will pick that up. I'll get you guys some close-up shots so you can see that. But that's a very nice touch as well. It's kind of like unexpected. I did watch a couple videos on these before I got them, so I kind of knew what to expect with these. And I also watched some UA videos, like the fake pairs on these, because I was generally curious. And all I gotta say is be careful, because those fake pairs, I mean, I can't tell a difference. So if you guys are looking to pick these up in the aftermarket, like, my advice is just know who you're dealing with and buy from a trusted source. This is $1,300, and I don't want anyone getting their head cracked, because if I paid $1,300 for a shoe and I got hit with a UA pair, I couldn't even imagine. But anyways, getting back into the shoe. Also, another detail I like is this little barcode right here with the Fragment Travis Scott. I don't know why, I just really like that touch. I think it's pretty cool. Love the cream midsole, as I mentioned, with the cream swoosh. And then the bottom, we got a blue outsole. And then the black toe, which kind of is like the OG Jordan 1 color blocking. And that's like another reason why I think I like these so much too, is that because it is the OG like Jordan 1 color blocking pretty much. And it's the closest to like the original Air Jordan 1 Fragment, which, in my opinion, the original Air Jordan 1 Fragment is one of the most overrated shoes of all time. I'm sorry, I said it. I mean, it's a white, black, and blue Jordan 1 with a Fragment logo on it, and people are paying like $5,000 for it. That's insane. But anyways, that's my hot take of the day. Also, we have a cream tongue, which is super nice, and we have the Nike Air logo right here. Now, interesting enough, I was watching a real versus fake yesterday, and the guy who had the real pair, his Nike Air right here, his whole logo, took up the whole white space, so there was really like no white space showing that wasn't covered by Nike Air. So maybe some factory imperfections on the tongue. So another like just throwing it out there that these are probably going to be tough as shit to legit check, because there's going to be so many quality control issues and stuff. So good luck if you're trying to pick these up on the aftermarket, because honestly, if you guys want my opinion, I'm going to tell you, A, I wouldn't even want to go after these on the aftermarket because I don't want to get hit with a UA pair. And second of all, having these in hand, I can honestly tell you guys, I would not pay $1,300 for these shoes. I'm sorry, I just wouldn't do it. It's a nice shoe, but I would not pay $1,300 for these. And that's the problem that I have, is that I want to wear these shoes. As a sneaker guy, I just like shoes. I don't really care about resale. Yeah, it's nice that shoes hold their value so that if I want to get rid of something and get something else, I could easily do that. But with a shoe like this, like, I actually want to wear it. But at the same time, this is $1,300. And I could do a lot with $1,300. Like, if these were $400 to $500, I would have no problem throwing these on my feet and like walking to the store or whatever. Like, I'd probably wear them tomorrow if that was the case. But $1,300, I mean, like I said, I could use that money towards like five different pairs of shoes or like jackets or whatever. $1,300 is a lot of money just for like a single pair of shoes. So that's kind of like the decision I have to decide myself. Now, if you got $1,300 to blow and you want these shoes really bad and you think these are worth it, by all means, go for it. I'm not going to stop you. If that's how you want to spend your money, go ahead. But For me, I'm straight on these for $1,300, but definitely, it is a really dope shoe. I think it's a well-executed collab. Very nice color blocking. Is it overhyped? Yes, but at the same time, it is a very dope-looking shoe, and I think they did a really good job. And if I had to rank them in the rest of the Air Jordan 1 Travis Scotts, these would probably be I'm going to say these are number 2 behind the original Air Jordan 1 Lows. So I'm going to go the original Air Jordan 1 Lows, these, the Air Jordan 1 Highs, the original brown ones, and then the Air Jordan 1 High fragments. So those would be my rankings of the Air Jordan 1, Travis Scott Air Jordan 1s. But yeah, that's going to be my video for today. Short little video. I know a lot of people have reviews out on these, so just wanted to give you guys my thoughts and opinions. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace!